Hello and welcome to Maths by SAS. This is my seventh lesson of D2, chapter number 2, exercise 2F. That is about application of simultaneous equations in real world. In this lesson, I will solve intermediate level question number 14. As the questions are long, so I will be reading the question from the book. Question 14 says, Lixin intends to buy either gift A, which costs $10, gift A, okay, and the cost of gift A is $10, or the gift B that costs $8, as a Christmas gift for each of her parents, two siblings, 13 relatives. For the parents, it's good to write the data in short form. Two siblings, 13 relatives, and 10 friends. Okay, and given that she intends to spend $230 is the amount that she wants to spend, find the number of each gift she should buy. Here the problem is that there are two or three informations given which will be helping us to solve the question. One of the information is that she intends to buy either the gift A or gift B, okay, and the cost of the gift A is $10 and cost of gift B is $8, and then the information is given for the total amount that she wants to spend, and then the information is given that how many presents she wants to give. So we have to keep these all informations in mind, and then we have to frame the two simultaneous equations. First of all, we have to suppose that what will be the expression for the type A gifts and what will be the expression for type B gifts. Let the number of type A gifts to buy equals to X. Let's move to the solution. Let the type A gifts to buy, type A gifts to buy equals to X, and the type B gifts to buy equals to Y. Now the problem is that she is spending $230 for that, and the cost of one gift of type A is $10 and cost of one gift of type B is $8. So in order to make the use of 230, what we have to do, we have to write the equation that will tell us that the total amount that she is spending will be in the form of 10x plus 8y equals to 230, and this will be one of my equations. Now what we have to do, I have to think about that how many total gifts she has to buy for type A and type B. That will be in form of x plus y equals to, now the type A and type B gifts will be for the parents. For that, I will write 2. Then for the siblings, again, I have to write 2. Then for the relatives, I have to write 13. And for friends, I have to write 10. And let me see what is the sum coming. 13 plus 10 is 23. 23 plus 2 is 25. Plus 2 is 27. So it means that the total of type A and type B gifts will be written in form of x plus y equals to 27. Now I'm getting these two equations. So what we have to do, we have to solve these two equations simultaneously. If we look at equation one carefully, we can see that I can extract 2 as a common factor from there. It's always good to extract some number or letter as a common factor and simplify your expression before moving to the next stage. So when I'm taking 2 as a common factor, inside the bracket I will left with 5x plus 4y equals to 2 multiplied by 230, when will be divided by 2 will give me 115. multiplied by 115. This 2 can be cancelled and I will left with 5x plus 4y equals to 115. Now this is the new equation. Let it be equation 3. Now it's the time to decide that which method we are going to use for the solution of this problem. I will be preferring substitution method from equation 2. What we can do from equation 2, I can make y the subject of formula easily. Y equals to 27 minus x. Now replace this value of y in equation 3. Replace this value of y in equation 3 and equation will take the form 5x plus 4y equals to 115. Instead of y, I have to replace plus 4 into 27 minus x equals to 115. Now apply distributive property carefully, that this 4 has to be multiplied with every term inside the bracket carefully, and the equation will take the form 5x plus 4 times 27, 7 fours are 28, 2 and 4 twos are 8 and 2 10, 108 minus 4x equals to 115. Now 5x and 4x are like terms. Write them together and solve them. This will give me x equals to 115 minus 108. And when I'm taking away 108 from 115, 108, x will be equal to 7. So if you look at the start of the question, we can see that x is a supposition for the type A gifts. So we are getting total 7 type A gifts. And now what we have to do, replace this value of x in A, replace x equals to 7 in A, and the equation will take the form y equals to 27 minus x, and y equals to 27 minus 7, which is equal to 20. And if we look at the question, we can see that y is the supposition for type B gifts. Now the question says, if we read the final part of the question, find the number of each type of gifts she should buy. So the number of each type of gifts she should buy, so the number of each type of gifts, each type of gifts are x, that is the type A is 7 and the B is 20. I hope you are clear about this question, and let's quickly move to the next question and read the question carefully. It's really important to read the question and underline important terms of the question. Okay, the next question is question number 15, and question says that there are some chickens and goats on a farm. Chickens and goats on a farm, given that the animals have total 50 heads. The information is about the heads, and we are having total 50 heads and 140 legs. Legs are 140, and the question says how many more chickens are there, more chickens than the goats. Okay, in order to get this information, first of all we have to solve the simultaneous equations given in the question. Question says that there are some chickens, so we have to suppose let the number of chickens on the farm are x, and the number of goats are y. Now there are two information given, one is about the heads and one is about the legs. We know that all the animals or birds can have only one head, so it means for 50, how to translate this information in form of the mathematical equation, that the number of heads of chicken plus number of heads of goat total equals to 50, and this is my one of the equations. And let's talk about the legs. And chicken have two legs and the goats have the four legs. So for this information, how to write the equation will be 2x plus 4y equals to goats equals to 140. Now, if we look at the second equation, we can see that we can simplify this equation. I can extract 2 as a common factor. So when I'm extracting 2 as a common factor, inside the bracket, I will left with x plus 2y equals to 2 times 70. And now this 2 can go with this 2. And I have the equation with me, x plus 2y equals to 70. Now, what we have to do, we have to think about the method that we can apply on this situation to solve the problem. Either I can go with the substitution method or elimination method. It's up to you. So I'm going with the elimination method. So I have to write both the equations together. X plus y equals to 50 and x plus 2y equals to 70. Now, what we have to do, we have to observe the coefficients of x. Here, the coefficient of x is 1. Here, the coefficient of x is 1 with the positive sign. Same coefficient, same sign. So, what we have to do, we have to subtract the equation or change the sign of this second equation. Please watch my previous lesson in which I have discussed all the rules, because for the clarity of every new lesson, it's important to have the integration with the previous lesson. Now, what we can do is, we can cancel this x with this x, and my equation will be only in one variable, and I will left with y minus 2y will be minus y equals to minus 20. Okay, and this minus sign will be going with minus sign, and y, that is the number of goats, is 20. Okay, so answer of y, one of the variable is 20, which is the supposition for goats. Now, in order to get value of x, what I have to do, replace y equals to 20 in equation 1, because that is the simplified equation that has the coefficients of x and y 1. So x plus y equals to 50, x plus y equals to 50, and y has the value 20 equals to 50. Shift 20 to this side, 50 minus 20, and x equals to 30. This is the second unknown of the question, and which is the supposition for chickens. And now the question says, how many more chickens than the goats? So the number of more chickens or now more chickens or more chickens or extra chickens, number of extra chickens, number of extra chickens will be, what we have to do, we can see the chickens are 30 and goats are 20. 30 minus 20 and 10. So there are 10 more chickens than goats. I hope you are clear about this lesson. For next difficulty level, please catch me in the next class. Watch my lessons, like, share and subscribe the channel, and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson.